Good day and welcome to the Harborview High School year-end concert. The first and hopefully the last concert needing to be recorded rather than take place in front of a live audience. Today's program includes our entire band program, our grade 9 band, grade 10 band, as well as our senior band. You'll also hear from our choral ensemble and our chaz choir, as well as two performances from our Theater Arts 12-0 class. If you'd like to scroll through to a specific part in the video, you can look in the timeline and you'll see chapter markers to specific ensembles. However, we do encourage you to watch the entire show. We certainly miss the buzz of a full auditorium, the energy of live concerts, and we very much look forward to their return in the near future. However, our Harborview music program continued on despite the pandemic. We taped off our parking spots, got out the puppy pads and sanitizer, and continued to make music together. Sometimes it had to be on buckets, but we found the fun. Every little cohort had its own vibe, and I think the smaller groups made room for some voices to be heard that may not have been in the before times. And when we were able to finally come together as a full band on stage, the sound surrounded us like a warm hug. Though there is no replacement for a live show, we hope that this recording captures just how much work, progress, and fun we achieved this year. Thank you to all of the band families for your commitment to the program this year and every year. Thank you for your trust in Harborview and in me with continuing to make music safely this year. We hope you have a restful summer, and I very much look forward to the after times full of concerts, band trips, and festivals. Enjoy the show.
Thank you. Okay, so today you'll be hearing a script written in Mrs. McDonald's writing 11-0 and 12-0 class. It was written by Casey Butler, and it's called Taco Bell Crunchwrap Supreme. And theater arts and writing paired up, and we did a reader's theater of all of their scripts. Normally we perform them, but this year we did reader's theater in the band room a few weeks ago, and it was hilarious. So much fun. So the point of reader's theater is to hear the script out loud, and Emily was in the writing class and wrote a script and was amazed to hear her words just even said out loud from a different perspective. So reader's theater is a really great way to workshop a script, and a super super fun way to go through scripts and read them and hear different voices. So today, Taco Bell Crunchwrap Supreme by Casey Butler, and I'm the narrator. I'll introduce the characters. Romeo is the fiancé, Rosaline, the ex-fiancé, Juliet, the cute new girl, Mercutio, the best man, cashier, just trying their best, and manager, doesn't get paid enough for this. That's so accurate. And Crunchwrap Supreme, the real star of the show. So I'll be reading the stage directions, they'll be reading the parts, and I'm also playing the manager. You guys all ready?
Yep.
Romeo, a young groom-to-be, is on his way to his bachelor party. He is currently riding in a limo, which is sitting in a Taco Bell drive-thru. He and the other patrons of the bachelor party are eagerly waiting to order.
Man, stopping at Taco Bell is the best idea we've ever had.
I know, right? What an awesome way to kickstart a bachelor party.
I can't believe we're getting married next month. Are you excited?
Duh! I'm as excited as I am to eat at Taco Bell Crunchwrap Supreme.
Romeo's phone rings in his pocket.
Oh, speaking of which, the lovely bride-to-be is calling me right now.
Romeo answers the phone. Rosaline's voice can be heard on speakerphone.
Rosaline, what's up, baby?
Hello, my darling. Where are you right now?
About to head to my killer bachelor party. Duh! We're at Taco Bell right now. Do you want me to pick you up a Taco Bell Crunchwrap Supreme?
Taco Bell?
Yeah!
A Crunchwrap Supreme?
Yeah.
Romeo. Romeo, I cannot believe you! For the 100th time, I am on a diet! I have told you this like 10 times this morning. It's like you never listened to me. I am so sick of it.
So, no Crunchwrap Supreme?
You know what? The wedding's off. I can't deal with you and your stupid Taco Bell obsession.
Wait, what? Baby, wait.
Goodbye, Romeo. And also, Del Taco is better.
Rosaline hangs up the phone. Everyone in the limo is silent for a moment. Romeo buries his head in his hands and sobs.
I can't believe this. How could she say Del Taco is better than Taco Bell?
Mercutio pats him on the back.
There, it's alright. She doesn't deserve you anyway. You're too good for her.
Mercutio, what am I supposed to do now? There's no wedding. That means no sick bachelor party.
Hey, I know what'll cheer you up.
Romeo sniffles.
What?
How about we park this cool limo, go inside, and sit down to eat some tacos like a family?
Sniffles again.
Okay.
The ensemble goes into the Taco Bell and gets in line. Ad lib if you want to. I don't control your life. Suddenly, Romeo spots Juliet. She's waiting in line directly in front of them. He whispers to Mercutio.
Bro, that girl is hot.
Dude, you just broke up your wedding 2 seconds ago.
So?
So? Oh, I'm proud of you for moving on, bro. Go get her, Tiger.
I can hear you, you know.
Romeo stares at her for a second, then turns back to Mercutio in a stage whisper.
Dude, she heard me. What do I do?
I can still hear you.
Crap. So you like Taco Bell?
I'm in one right now.
Oh, right. Well, what's your favorite thing to get?
Well, I really like this Crunchwrap Supreme.
Dude, no way! I love Crunchwrap Supremes. They're like my favorite food.
Mine too. Wow, this is so crazy.
Hey, do you want to sit down and eat Crunchwrap Supremes together?
Whoa, before marriage? That's kind of scandalous, but sure.
I can help. Who's next in line?
Romeo and Juliet walk up to the cashier together. The cashier is wearing a sticker indicating it is their first day on the job.
We would like 2 Crunchwrap Supremes, please.
And make sure mine has no onions, because
I'm deathly allergic to onions.
Wait.
Oh my goodness. You're deathly allergic to onions too? And your favorite food is Taco Bell Crunchwrap Supreme?
Romeo wipes a tear of joy from his eye.
You know, my ex-fiance broke up with me 2 minutes ago. I thought I would never find love again. But now, meeting you and knowing you love Crunchwrap Supremes, I think you proved me wrong.
Romeo drops to one knee, pulling out a ring pop.
I was saving this for my wedding, but I think this is much more fitting.
Juliet doing that shocked, excited, hands over mouth thing people do during proposals.
Oh my god, oh my god!
Will you, wait, what's your name again?
Juliet.
Juliet, will you marry me?
Yeah, I guess so.
The restaurant cheers. While the proposal was happening, the Crunchwrap Supremes had been prepared, and cashier hands them over with happy tears in their eyes.
And now for a celebratory Crunchwrap Supreme.
Romeo takes a bite only to immediately begin dramatically choking for air before dropping to the ground. He is deceased.
Romeo, oh my god, how did this happen?
Julia drops to her lover's side. She sees the Crunchwrap Supreme in his hand.
Wait a minute, this Crunchwrap Supreme has onion. Extra onion. Like, this thing is 80% onion.
Suddenly, the manager, who had come out of his office due to all the commotion, points at the cashier accusingly.
You fool! Taco Crunchwrap Supremes already come with no onions! Hitting the no onion button on an order that comes without onions just adds extra onions. Anybody would know that.
It's my first date. Also, that seems very complicated and contrived.
Mercutio collapses next to Romeo's corpse, wailing in sorrow and pounding the ground dramatically.
All I wanted was to eat together like a gosh dang family for once.
Julia weeping.
This is the worst 5 minutes of my life. The love of my life is dead. Onions have been his timeless end. Oh, happy Crunchwrap Supreme.
She picks up the Crunchwrap Supreme.
This is thy onion.
She takes a bite.
There, crunch, and let me die.
Juliet dies. There is a pause as the onlookers take a moment of silence for the lovers' deaths. Suddenly, a person in the crowd speaks up.
So, do you think maybe we should have stopped her?
There's another pause as the crowd digests its incompetence.
Oops.
A glooming peace, this Taco Bell with it brings. The cook, for sorrow, will not shake his head. Go hence, to have more talk of these sad things. And also, get out of the way for when the police arrive. Most shall be pardoned, and someone will probably be arrested. For never was a story of more crap than that of Juliet and her Crunchwrap. A pause. You're fired! Except.
Thank you. Ever calling me home. Thank you. Thank you. Subject.